By the time this video comes out, most people with MS have had or at least been offered the first COVID vaccine dose. And here at the MS Trust, we've seen an increasing amount of questions with regards to side effects, but also how to prepare for the second dose. So we wanted to get some answers to these questions. So once again, we have neurologist Alasdair Coles from Addenbrooke Hospital with us to hopefully clear some of these questions up. Hi, Alasdair.
Hello there. It's a pleasure to be back with you again.
Thank you so much for doing this. All right. The first question we have, starting with the AstraZeneca vaccine, which there's been quite a lot of talk about recently. So which parts of Europe and US being cautious about the AstraZeneca jab and recent government guidance of offering alternatives for the under 30s? What reassurance is there that this is safe for people of the UK, particularly if people are not so mobile?
Yes, so I can understand everyone's concern about this because the headlines are really very worrying that the AstraZeneca vaccine is associated with people having blood clots in the brain. And some of those people have died. And clearly, this is a very serious potential side effect. I think the important thing to bear in mind is just how rare this is. So in the UK, something like 79 cases have been described with this, of whom 19 have died out of a total of 20 million people who've received the vaccine. So if you do the sums on that, that comes to roughly 1 in 100,000 chance of having this side effect. And so to put that in perspective, your chance of having a blood clot after the AstraZeneca vaccine are about the same as dying from a general anaesthetic, and about the same as dying if you drive every day on the roads in England for a year. So those are the sort of risks we're talking about. So clearly a very worrying side effect, very unpleasant if you get it, but extremely rare. And as you know, the vaccine has been advised to not be given to people under the age of 30 in this country, and for people in that age group to have other forms of the COVID vaccine.
Right. So if you've had the AstraZeneca for the first dose, myself, I'm one of these people, and if you're worried now, can you take a second dose with a different vaccine, or should you still stick to the AstraZeneca?
Yeah, so I would encourage you to stick with the AstraZeneca. I think the benefits are likely to be greater than if you try another vaccine, although we're not sure about that. No one's really done that test. Clearly, if your anxiety is overwhelming and it would really be a big burden on you to take another AstraZeneca vaccine, you could talk to your doctors, your GP, or your vaccine provider about an alternative.
Here's a question regards to the Moderna vaccine. And we had a question from someone who says that they're allergic to contrast, which they've seen is in the Moderna vaccine, which they were scheduled to have. So what should they do?
Yes, so each of the vaccines comes with a list of things that the vaccine contains, which might be simple chemicals just in terms of gluing everything together in the vaccine shot that you're given. And if you are potentially allergic, you should check those. Now, I did, I knew this question was coming, and I looked up the Moderna ingredients, and I didn't actually see contrast in there. So I think that it's a good question to ask, but it's well worth clarifying before making any decisions about the Moderna vaccine.
Right. If you and this is for all the different versions of the vaccine, if you reacted badly during the after the first jab, would you expect that to sort of happen with the second? And should you still have the second jab if you had a bad reaction. We've had heard some people sort of feel really rotten after the first time.
Yes, I know that, and people close to me have had a really bad experience of both the Pfizer and the AstraZeneca vaccines in terms of those general sort of flu-like symptoms that you can get. Yes. And the experience both from these vaccines and from other vaccines that we've been using in the past is that the second dose will be the same or slightly less in terms of the severity of side effects, usually.
And is there anything that can be done before or after vaccination to sort of try and prevent some of these side effects? Like, is there, for instance, any advice like taking paracetamol and...
Yeah, that's right. So the side effects that are most common after vaccines that feel like you've got the flu, so headaches and a fever and chills and shakes, are all due to cytokines in the bloodstream that are released in response to the vaccine or in response to a virus if you've got the flu. So it's the same sort of mechanism, and the same sort of measures will help. So resting, drinking lots, keeping your temperature down if you can, and taking the paracetamol or aspirin or something like that to reduce the temperature will work. And in the same spirit, taking paracetamol before you have the vaccine may help to reduce these side effects.
What has the frequency of side effects been after the first jab? Has any of them sort of caused any longer lasting MS symptoms or relapses and things like that?
Yeah, so the most common side effect is pain at the injection sites, and 90% of people report that. 70% of people will report a headache or feeling a bit lousy. Something like 50% of people will report muscle ache and that sort of feeling. Mm. And people will have a documented fever, a high temperature, in about 15% of cases. So that's the normal range. Mm. And people with MS will experience all of those things and may also experience a worsening of their neurological symptoms. So very commonly, people might experience their legs going stiffer and weaker and their bladder becoming less reliable. And this usually lasts for several days and in all the cases that I'm aware of, resolves completely and people are back to where they were before the vaccine within a week. And I think the explanation for this is very clear and simple, and it's reassuring. People may think, oh my goodness, I'm having a relapse of my MS, this is a disaster. But actually, I don't think it is that. The explanation is the same explanation for people whose symptoms get worse if they have an ordinary infection or if they get hot for some other reason. And this is simply due to the unreliability of nerves that have been damaged in the past when the body gets hot. And so symptoms from the past will reappear, or symptoms in the present will get worse because nerves just are not very good at working when the body is hot. So after a few days, this should all settle down. And I'm not aware of anyone having long-lasting harm from those MS symptoms induced by the vaccine.
That's good. We've been encouraging people to sort of report anything to the yellow card system if they've had any sort of side effects that have been strange. We're talking a lot about side effects now. I have to say, though, most cases that we've heard, people have been fine. They've been feeling tired or have, like you said, the injection site problem. Mm. So just to reassure people that these are still very small percentage of people we're talking about. But you mentioned bladder control. Somebody said that they lost bladder control the day after the vaccine. Is it likely that that would happen again then with the second dose?
Yes. So I think all of these symptoms that people might have experienced with the first dose might reoccur with the second dose. Just like with all potential side effects, they could be the same or possibly slightly less severe with the second dose than with the first. And I'd encourage people not to let that put them off if they can.
And that's the same. Then we've heard a few people who said that they've had issues with their legs and mobility.
Yeah.
And I, yeah. And is it still okay for them to take a second dose?
Yes, because of course the worry that people might well have is that they're causing themselves permanent harm by having these vaccines.
Yeah.
And therefore their walking or their bladder control will never be the same again. And I can understand that. But I'd want to reassure people that that isn't the case, that these symptoms will resolve and people will get back to where they were before their first vaccine.
And we were talking about taking paracetamol and things. I know a few MS nurses have sort of said that really do take it easy after you had the vaccine, sort of, and rather than run around and do lots of things.
I mean, I think that's good. That's good homely advice to take it easy. I think people who haven't yet had their first vaccine, if there are any left, you know, should expect not to feel great for a few days and not plan difficult work things or social events. So they're not putting themselves under unnecessary strain at a time when they may not be feeling 100%.
Here's a question that's not completely MS related, but there's been a lot of talk, well, not a lot of talk, but a few questions about this. And it's the sort of the future of fertility or future pregnancies. Is there any sort of effects that we've heard of with the vaccine for this?
Yes, so I've heard a concern about this. And again, it would be very worrying to think that taking a vaccine now might impair the chances of having a family in the future. I really don't understand this concern. I don't know where it's come from and it doesn't make sense to me scientifically. And I've not seen any information on that.
No.
But clearly, it would be very early days to know. Yeah. But I'm not aware of any vaccine that has an impact.
Oh,
I really don't imagine that COVID vaccine.
So does having the vaccine now mean that you can relax your guard and life can sort of return to normal? Or should we still be following all the social distancing guidelines?
Yes. I mean, it is a natural reaction. When you've had that second vaccination, to think all the risks are over now.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, that isn't the case. And I mean, I know this well because my poor son had mumps when he was 11 years old, despite the fact he'd had all the appropriate MMR vaccinations. Good reminder to me, and it's a good reminder for everyone, that vaccines aren't 100% effective at the individual level. And really what vaccines are intended to do is to give population immunity, that phrase herd immunity that we've heard a lot of. So your best chance of not getting COVID is if the people around you are vaccinated, and if the people around them are vaccinated, and if the whole nation is vaccinated, and if we're all vaccinated. But at the level of the individual, if you've been vaccinated and you go into an area where there's high COVID rate, you may well get COVID. The symptoms are likely to be less, and the chance of severe disease is much likely to be less if you've been vaccinated, but it is certainly not a foolproof defence against personally getting COVID.
Yeah, and especially now when things are opening up and people are starting to sort of come out. I mean, a lot of the people, I think, we're down to 45 in my area now, where people are, year of 45, where people are getting the vaccine. So there's still a lot of people that haven't been off for the first dose.
Yeah, so I think the first thing to do is to be honest about your own risk of severe COVID disease. So if you're young, fit, healthy with MS and you've been vaccinated, that risk is low. If you're older, if you're overweight with high blood pressure and diabetes, you know, your risks of severe COVID disease remain high if you get COVID. So firstly, you know, make a calculation about your own individual risk and then think, well, what risks am I willing to take in terms of my exposure to COVID? So, you know, going to a crowded town centre is not a great idea if you're trying to avoid getting COVID infection. And that is still the case.
And my last question, is there any evidence about how severely people are affected who have been vaccinated and still caught COVID? I mean, you said that the chances are that you wouldn't.
Yeah, so the evidence, generally speaking, so this isn't for people with MS, but in particularly older folk who've been vaccinated may well still get COVID infection, but it's quite clear that the vaccination will protect them from the more severe forms of the illness. So that's really good news.
Yeah.
Really good. And of course, the best bit of news, if that was your last question, is just to remind everyone that we in the UK are doing fantastically well in terms of this COVID rollout. And I'd really encourage everyone to take part in that. You know, be good news to the people around you and get yourself vaccinated, that if you haven't already done so. And then just a reminder that if you are someone who is in a high risk category, then you should get vaccinated, but also those around you have a high priority for getting vaccinated now. So if you're in a household with, you know, younger people who've not yet been offered the vaccine, and yet you're in a high risk group, then do talk to your local doctor or vaccine center, because those in your household should be getting vaccinated soon as well. So that's a bit of news for you.
That's really good advice, actually, because we've heard people sort of ask about things like that, especially people who have got family members with MS.
Yeah. Yeah, so that's a recent change. It's on the government website. So do, if you're in that category, do go out there and get those people in your household vaccinated alongside yourself.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for talking to us again. That's really cleared up a lot of our questions.
It's a great pleasure.
Thank you.